your purpose. One question that I always ask myself, even as I would always ask myself, is what's your purpose for living?
You can't make time for you. Warning, warning, warning. You won't make time for anyone else or me. Time alone, again, will make you see what will fit you, what's suitable for your life. If you think your life is falling apart, it's not falling apart. It's actually sometimes falling in place, because there were times where in life I thought, and you know, what is there to live for? But I held on, you know.
like, bitch, getting this money, buying more clothes. I look nice, right? You be in that fake shit, and I seen yours twice. Your shoes, you weave in your purse. If you're bad, believe that I'm worse. You be online doing mad research, trying to cop some shit. You see me in first. Yeah, I make this way too easy. You can watch me more than your TV. Make sure she see I'm the main bitch on the show, like Mo, yeah, Kim and Lisa.
There's nothing that I won't do to avoid being a loser. And if you think you could have done more, you're a loser.
I wasn't talented. I wasn't talented in bodybuilding. I didn't have any genetics, but I had this attitude that I can do it. There's nothing I can't do. I believe that. I can squat. I can do anything.
There's a reason people won't squat. It's hard. It's hard. People don't want what's hard. They want what's easy, what looks showy. Forget about it. The same thing in life is the same thing here. If you can do this, you can do anything. Anything.
Yourself.
You have to achieve failure. You have to take it that far. Nobody wants to go that far. It's too scary. But you know something? I got news for you. That's where winning is.
Human.
damn button. Squeeze it. Ah. What? Squeeze.
Oh, my. You just chat.
Yeah. Kill me.
They want it up.
Squeeze it. Up. Squeeze.
On it. Yeah. Yeah.
Was this?
I do not ever want to go home from the gym going, I'm a loser, I could have done more. There is nothing that I won't do. There's nothing that I won't do to avoid being a loser. And if you think you could have done more, you're a loser.
Reality was forget about reality. I have to have a dream. I have to have a goal. I have to get up every morning and go after something. And I believe that bodybuilding and fitness makes your life better. But some of the young 20-year-olds, they say things to me like, isn't it really sad, Tom, that you gained all that muscle in the 1980s only to lose it now? Muscle's temporary. It's a temporary thing. So is life. I mean, so is life itself. It's temporary. It's all temporary. Someday, it's going to be your last day. Someday, it's going to be our last day. So I'm going to live every day as if it's my last day.
Fucking scientist to fucking logically understand what I'm saying. The more you put in, the more you get out. So stop fucking making excuses. Get out there and do whatever the fuck it takes to reach your fucking goals. Jesus Christ.
You're not bulking, you're just fat and worthless. Shoving your face with Big Macs, right? Like a fat little bitch, you know, piggy boy. And telling yourself, oh, it's the bulk, telling your friends it's the bulk. No, that shit ended, all right? You're just fat, lazy, and undisciplined. And you eat like shit, and you're fat. Did I mention you're fat?
When I was 10 years old, my father died from cancer. And my father died in 30 days. He died. He was a star like that. 10 years after that, my mother died. I just started doing a lot of research on health, how to eat. Because nobody in my family ate right. They would always just eat anything. And then that led me into the gym. And in the gym, I found peace because it was almost like a therapy for myself. I found something that nobody could take away from me. I just took all the passion out into eating, sleeping, and training. I didn't want to go to school or anything like this because all the kids were laughing at me in school because I didn't have a father. But I had that gym, you know, and that gym taught me a discipline, taught me sacrifice, and it just taught me how to trust my decisions. We'll be right back. tore my chest. I snapped my tendon, tore my chest with 300 kilos bench pressing. You know what they said? I'll never come back. I'll never be a bodybuilder. I'll never. This happened after I got second place in my first semester. You know what happened? I was the first bodybuilder in the universe that ever came back from this and won a show. I won 23 shows after that. And it wasn't just a tear. I had major surgery. Like, I tore my pectoralis major minor and snapped my tendon in half. If I can make it through that and deal with that, I can almost do anything. Because the world said it was impossible, right? That's how you look at your situations that you're dealing with. I look at it as a challenge. Don't make sense now, but it'll make me a better person. Discipline is what it takes to be successful. Whatever it is that you want to do in life, you always have to just sacrifice. So sacrifice is the number one thing. You know, there's no secret. There's no secret. The secret lies within you. So I can tell people how I train. I can tell them what I eat and all these things. That's the boring part, you know? Anybody can train and eat, but what's driving you to do what you do in life? This is the most important thing. What drives you? Because what drives you will be an influence to someone else. Care about how big my arms is or how much I can bench press in the gym. You know, it's not about how you look, it's about connecting with someone.
I did not like living in reality. Reality was forget about reality. I have to have a dream. I have to have a goal. I have to get up every morning and go after something. And I believe in that bodybuilding and fitness is makes your life better. But some of the young 20-year-olds, they say things to me like, isn't it really sad, Tom, that you gained all that muscle in the 1980s only to lose it now? Muscle's temporary. It's a temporary thing. So is life. I mean, so is life itself. It's temporary. It's all temporary. Someday, it's going to be your last day. Someday, it's going to be our last day. So I'm going to live every day as if it's my last day and do stuff that I always wanted to do because I don't want to go, oh man, I'm dying tomorrow. I'm dying now and I missed it.
Going to the gym. You want success. You want results. You have to do something about it. You just can't hope for it. You can't expect it just to happen because you showed up. You can't just expect it to happen because you did a few of these and a few of those and, you know, you ate some protein and all that stuff. You have to take action. You have to demand it from the universe. You have to demand it from your workouts and insist that it happens right now, here and now. And without that kind of lead up, you're just spinning your wheels. You're not really doing anything. You're just pretending to be some kind of bodybuilder or something like that.
In the fundamentals, properly defined, intensity refers to the percentage of possible momentary muscular effort being exerted. Does anyone require that I state that again? Got it? Now, since the definition I just gave you is rather abstract or technical, in fact, when I first read that definition, I didn't have the slightest clue. What the hell does that mean, I thought. Now I do understand it perfectly. The best way to clarify a highly abstract or technical definition is to go to a concrete example in perceptual reality. You, like any healthy, well-conditioned person, are capable of exerting yourself with a maximum effort at any given moment.
When I was 10 years old, my father died from cancer. And my father died in 30 days. He died. He was just gone like that. 10 years after that, my mother died. Cancer. I just started doing a lot of research on health, how to eat. Because nobody in my family ate right. They would always just eat anything. And then that led me into the gym. And in the gym, I found peace because it was almost like a therapy for myself. I found something that nobody could take away from me. I just took all the passion out into eating, sleeping, and training. I didn't want to go to school or anything like this because all the kids were laughing at me in school because I didn't have a father. But I had that gym, you know, and that gym taught me a discipline, taught me sacrifice, and it just taught me how to trust my decisions.
Hand in hand, just to now, face to face.